Hello everyone. I know it's late, but I will try to do my best to make this to make you not feel tired about this presentation. And in this talk, I'm going to describe how you can use Microsoft Cognitive Services to detect human emotion and also interpret image content to make your apps AI enabled. So it means that you can create with Microsoft Cognitive Services, you can create apps which are very smart and can read what they see. So specifically, this talk will be about detecting human emotions. So to give you the overview of how this service works, I will show you the video in which I have the custom app, in which I acquire image from the webcam, and then every time I press the button, detect emotion, the current frame is sent to the cloud, to the Microsoft Cognitive Service process over there, and then the detected emotion is displayed on the image. So let's see how does it work. So I started the preview, and then every time I press this button, the current frame is sent to the cloud, analyzed, and the detected emotion as well as the face box is overlaid on the image to indicate detected emotion. So you can see I can make several different faces, poses, and all of them are quite well detected by this service. And the other part of the talk is dedicated to interpreting image content. So the first service I showed in the previous slide is called Emotion API, and this guy is called Vision Service, and you can use it to detect what is to recognize objects, various objects on your image. Specifically in this example, I'm showing that Vision Service is able to detect the dog which carries the frisbee in his mouth. So it looks pretty exciting. And now, what are the applications for this technology? So like 2 weeks ago at the Build conference in Seattle, which I was attending, during one of the first plenary talks, Satya, the CEO of Microsoft, has presented the application of this Microsoft Cognitive Services to create the app which provides the safe workplace. So what this app does, it detects people and devices in the images which are acquired from the webcams, and then it can detect like any suspicious or incorrect behavior of employees, and then send corresponding message to their managers so they can take actions and to protect their employees. And the other application of the Microsoft Cognitive Services is this Seeing AI project, in which the eyewear displayed in the corner is combined with this Microsoft Cognitive Services to help people who are visually impaired. So this eyewear in the middle has the, in front of this eyewear, there is a camera which acquires the images seen by the person. And every time the person swipes a gesture tab on the eyewear, it sends the image to the Microsoft Cognitive Services and then gives the user a description of what he should see. So I will turn on this video, although we cannot like see everything. I will try to like give a quick overview of what is happening. So basically you can watch it also on the YouTube, and this video tells the story about this engineer who is visually impaired, and he wears this eyewear to help him like in everyday life. So basically, as you can see, he uses this stick to find his way to the work or wherever he's going to. And this eyewear helps him to accomplish his task. So when he's talking to people, he can always like ask the Microsoft Cognitive Services to tell him what is in his scene. So I will try to move it a little bit forward to give some, to show some more demos. Unfortunately, we don't have sound now, but basically it's just to give you the overview of how the Seeing AI project is about. So I also encourage you to like watch this video on YouTube. So it's an example. So he sees some person on the skateboard, and he sends this image to the Microsoft Cognitive Services, and they send him the response, which is read to him that this is a guy which is on the skateboard. Okay, so let's move forward to other applications of this technology. So you can always build like very smart apps, but you can also build just the intelligent bot for Messenger using this Microsoft Cognitive Services. And here I'm showing results of the bot, Facebook Messenger bot, which I built. And this bot uses the Microsoft Cognitive Services to detect image content. So you send the pictures to this bot, exactly the same as you send images to your friends or family. And as a response, this bot tells you what he sees in this image. So you can see in this decent amount of examples that Microsoft Cognitive Services can be used to detect a lot of various objects in the image with very good accuracy. So specifically, what I like the most is that it quite good detects the sandwich with meat and lettuce. And the question is how to build such an AI-enabled apps. So the solution is pretty straightforward. What you need to do, you first sign up for a free account in Microsoft Cognitive Services, which are also known as the Project Oxford. And then you need to acquire or load an image, send it to a service for analysis, and then parse the response, and you can further utilize this response for like further processing. So the sample app, which I built with this Emotions Cognitive Services, is using the Universal Windows platform. And there you have like, so you need to capture the image. And to capture the image in the Universal Windows platform, you need just two things. So the first one is the capture element, which is a XAML control. And the other thing is the media capture. So the control displays images you acquire, and the media capture is responsible for all the logic which acquires physically the images from the camera. So how does it look like in the code? So as I said, you need to like declare capture element in your XAML. And then, so here is the actual code of this app, which I shown in the beginning. So I have like this two buttons and the capture element. And those buttons are used to like start and stop preview. And the second button is used to send current frame to the Emotion API for processing. And then I have this media capture class, which I use to stream data from my webcam. And to use this class, it's like pretty straightforward. What you need to do is to initialize this class with appropriate settings, which are represented as the media capture initialization settings. So in this case, I use these settings to say to the media capture that I'm going to acquire video only. So I specify streaming capture mode to video. And then I pass the settings to the initialization method. And then I need to associate this media capture class with my capture element, which is declared in the XAML source. Once this is done, I need to start, and I can start or stop the preview with start preview async and stop preview async methods. I also wrap them around some additional logic which helps me to track if preview is actually started or not. And then once you start the preview, the image will be displayed in the capture element. But to send the image to Emotion API, what you need is the actual bitmap which is displayed. So to capture the bitmap, you can use the code which is displayed here. So basically, what you need to do, you need to set up the encoding parameters, which are in this example set to the bitmap format. Then I create the memory stream to which I capture the image acquired with the webcam using the capture photo to stream async method of the media capture class. And then this stream is converted to my format using the appropriate bitmap decoder. Once this is done, I just return the software bitmap, which I then can send for analysis. And how to implement this analysis in your app? Basically, you can use the appropriate NuGet package, which you install exactly the same as any other NuGet. Specifically, the name of the NuGet package is displayed here. So once you install that, you can start sending your images to the Emotion API for processing. So what actually happens after you send your image? So this Emotion API service, it sends you back the JSON array, which contains the face rectangle object. It specifies where is the face located on your image. And also it sends you the array of scores. And those scores tells you what is the probability of detecting the particular emotion in the image. So as you can see, the Emotion API can detect several different emotions like anger, contempt, fear, happiness, or neutral, sadness, and surprise. And in that case, I display the emotion which has the highest score. So as you can see in that case, since I'm looking very surprised, this service has put like almost 100% score to the surprise emotion, while the other emotions have very, very small scores. So in the code, it looks like that. So I take the image displayed, take the image which was acquired by the webcam, display it in the user interface of my app, and then send it to the Emotion API. And afterwards, after getting the emotion information, I display it to the user. So basically, to set up your Emotion Service client, which is provided by this SDK I mentioned before, you just use the constructor with the key you obtain when you set up your account in the Microsoft Cognitive Services. And then, given the bitmap I acquired from the webcam, I send it to the Emotion API service with this recognize async method. And then I process the result of this method, which is the emotion object. And this emotion object here, it contains the face box rectangle and also those scores which specify detected emotions. So given this face box and the scores of emotions, what I need to do, I need to draw this like rectangle over the face, which is pretty straightforward with Universal Windows Platform, but also you can use it in other platforms, as I will show very quickly. And then I need to read the emotion with the highest score, which I do with this pretty straightforward code. So I just use the scores property, convert it to the rank list, and take the key of the first element on this list. And how about other platforms? Can we use these services in other platforms? the answer is positive. Actually, those services can be used with any platform. The only requirement is that you need to appropriately send the request, web API request, to the Microsoft cognitive services, and then read the response. Instead of like sending the local file, you can also send the URL to your like image, so you don't need to bother of like acquiring images from the webcam. You can also like process images which you have somewhere in your app. And here I also use this Emotion API service in this tiny IoT device, which was connected to the low budget webcam, which you can buy for like $20. And this device is the Raspberry Pi, which you also can buy relatively cheap. And then I combine the Emotion API with this device. So I have this low budget device with the which runs the same code as this desktop app, because it uses the universal Windows platform, so I can directly deploy the same code to this small device. However, this device, when run in the headless mode, when I have no display connected to it, it is controlled with the tiny joystick which is attached to the SenseHut add-on board, and then detected emotions are displayed as the uniform color, which is as a uniform color of the LED arrays, of the LED array. So here is how does it look like. I have this tiny device. I have a joystick over there, and whenever I press the button, the preview starts, and then I can put the joystick down, which will trigger, which will acquire the current frame from the webcam and send it to the Emotion API for processing. And here, instead of what I had in this desktop app, I only display the emotion color. So when I detect particular emotion, instead of drawing the face box around the face, I just drive those 64 RGB LEDs to some particular color corresponding to the emotion detected by the Emotion API. So this part was devoted only to detecting human emotion, and let's switch now to using the vision service for interpreting image content. So basically this service can be used exactly in a very similar fashion as the Emotion API, but instead of like Emotion NuGet package, you need to install the vision package, which comes from the project Oxford. And also your response may be more complex because this service implements more methods. And these methods can be used to not only to read what is in the image, but also to recognize text and also get the image tags and so on. So for example, when you send like the picture with some text to this vision service client, it will respond with the detected text, and as you can see, it works pretty well, even though it's not like the text which we type on the page. It's text written on the book cover. And also, if you like send the real image, the vision service will respond to you depending on the method you use. But here I'm invoking the method which gives me the description of the image. And when I send the picture of the large city, I get the response description with the confidence. And this confidence tells you what's the probability that the service is right. So this confidence is similar to the scores which are returned by the Emotion API. And also when you send like a car image, it also quite good, recognizes the color and the fact that this is a car. And again, for other images, it works pretty similar. So we saw this dog already. And here I can send a picture of the woman. And the service returned me the response, a beautiful woman standing on a beach with the confidence of almost 70%. So as you can see, this works like, for me, it's pretty amazing that it works so simple, that you just send the image and almost immediately you have like a response which tells you exactly what is on the image. So how you can go further, where you can use those services? So probably you have a lot of ideas now, but one of the application I also used for this service was to build the bot, Facebook Messenger bot, using this Microsoft bot service. And I will briefly tell you how I did it. So first I created the web app in the Azure. And then I set up all the like the web app name and pricing tier and so on. And then I created the app in a Visual Studio using this bot application project template. And this template already gives you like the sketch of your application with some sample functionality, so you to speed up your development. So when you create this app, it comes with the messages controller, which is the web API controller, exactly the same as you use for your MVC apps in ASP.NET. So what you need to do, you just need to like implement it according to your needs. And here I have like the post method, which responds to the messages sent by the user. And it's like pretty long, but what you need to do. So by default, this method will just respond with the message you sent and also give you the number of characters in your messages, in your message. And this functionality is contained in this else statement. And I just omit it because it's quite straightforward. But what's interesting is that when I detect some attachments sent to my bot, attachments as the which can be the in the form of image, I send them to my vision service client and then analyze the response which I get from the service. So basically I check if the content type of the attachment is image, and if so, I get the image description with the Microsoft Cognitive Services, and then reply this description to my bot user. And in this bot framework, you also have this, which I will show in a while. You also have like the chat, which you can use to test your bot. And again, it's like pretty similar to what you do in the messenger. You just use this tiny icon in the bottom left corner to send some image, and the bot will respond with the description of this image. So as you can see, I mean, I test many different images, and every time I had a feeling that this vision service client was working pretty well, except the fact that it confused the man with the woman in this first image. But I think that's okay. And it also confused the kite with some birds. But anyway, yes, and there is also a funny example that it thinks that the cloud over the building is the bird. But even though it looks pretty okay, in most examples it works pretty well. Of course, you can also check the confidence to like decide if this response is really useful for you. So to wrap up, I shown how you can use this artificial intelligence modules delivered by Microsoft Cognitive Services and that they can be used to build the AI-enabled apps during the weekend. And it is also worth to note that at the Build conference, like almost 2 years, two weeks ago, Microsoft has announced that they extended the Microsoft Cognitive Services, and specifically now they let you to build your own custom machine learning models to develop the computer vision models. So basically you provide your own images with the labels, and that's how you train your model, so you can tailor this model to your specific application. And as the last part of the talk, I'd like to show you some real-time demo of the bot framework, of the bot connected to Microsoft Cognitive Services. So I try to switch to my mobile phone and send some pictures I take now, provided it will work. Okay, so it looks like it's working. And now I will take some picture using my phone. I will switch the camera to the front camera, so probably you can see me now. Oh, something is broken. Okay. Yes, I will use this photo. Now turn around. So the photo has been... Probably I don't have a... Oh, I have the connection. Yes, that's always the case when you want to do the demo and something stop working. But anyway, this chat works exactly the same as I showed in my slides. So basically, you can send image to the bot and it responds with the description. Maybe I will try to make a picture with the other camera. Say I will do like that. Yes, it doesn't work. So something I tested before the presentation, but now it for some reason doesn't want to work. Anyway, this chat service, it comes from the bot framework website, which you use to create and deploy your bots with the Microsoft bot framework. Yeah, so let's switch back to my PC. So I just want to give some final comments. Specifically, if you are interested in this topic, I encourage you to read my book, which comes next Monday. And also, if you go there to the website of this book, there are like full source code used for this book, and you can find there also those sample apps for detecting emotions I shown here. And as a last slide, I'd like to announce that at the new lab, biophotonics lab, at the Polish Academy of Science, where I work on daily basis, we have several PhD students and engineering positions available. So if you are interested in developing new optical modalities, you are more than welcome to shoot us an email. So thank you very much for your attention, and I hope you enjoyed this presentation. Thanks.